about to be dispatched at the 1200 mark. It's been a great battle for favouritism. It's with Rockanuri and Willie Pike. They're off their racing. All day session jump well. Pooley away very quickly. Man Crush only began fairly. Double Spices charging forward, but look at Pooley go. Pooley's going to lead them at the end of 200. Double Spice striding up to second from Cliffs of Comfort. Man Crush deeper from All Day Session. Rockanuri, and the pace is furious. Two lengths Hint of Mint. Featherweight right back there in the field at the 800, followed by Vane Tempest, and toward the tail is Bumper Blast. Well, Pooley got hold of the bridle here and he wanted a charge coming down the side. Romilly trying to slow him down. It's Pooley with the head on the chest. He's flying by a length over Double Spice and Cliffs of Comfort. Man Crush was able to work its way across. Back on the inside, All Day Session. The pace certainly is going to suit the back markers. Rockanuri, Hint of Mint, Featherweight, followed by Vane Tempest and then Bumper Blast, but Pooley still led. 300 to go from Double Spice, Cliffs of Comfort, Man Crush under pressure. Here comes Rockanuri, Vane Tempest, Featherweight further the back. Pooley the leader from Double Spice. Pike is willing. The favourite Rockanuri, and here's Vane Tempest, but Rockanuri hits the front. Rockanuri, Vane Tempest coming, and Rockanuri holds on. Pike with a treble. Rockanuri held on from Vane Tempest. All Day Session, I thought, might be third from Featherweight. Man Crush, and back near the inside, Pooley, who gave them something to catch. And then came Double Spice, who had to weaken. Cliffs of Comfort, followed by Hint of Mint, who didn't fire at all. And the last of them home is Bumper Blast. Well, it's Rockanuri that wins it on the back up. Grant and Alana Williams coming up with a double today. Pike with a treble, joining Brad Parnham. And he rode desperately on Rockanuri as Vane Tempest started to whittle the margin down late. Rockanuri, having its third run in the preparation, though, has been able to hold on and win. Willie Pike aboard from Vane Tempest, Clint Johnston Porter. And All Day Session got the bob of the heads for third in front of either Man Crush or Pooley. Pooley gets fourth, Man Crush fifth. 5-3-8-4 they are, 5-3-8-4. And Featherweight, the next of them home. And the margins are a neck and a length and a quarter. They looked as though they were really charging, with Pooley responsible for a time of 1:10.88. 1:10.88, 34.95, the 600. So it was set up for a horse with the capacity to get over the back of them with that frenetic top-end speed, and it was Rockanuri. Is by Awesome Rock from Nishikawa for Neil Pinner. The Unger family, Tony Bahagias, a good day for Madame's Pinner Bahagia. Raced also by the McLernans, along with G. Ralston, A. Davidson, Chris Chalwell, Ross Fitzgerald, Craig Sherry, Brad Starkey, Trevor Nisbet, A.D. Young, Neil Warburton, M. Banks, and also Alana Williams and L. Trevanian. So Willie Pike with his third win this afternoon. He and Brad Parnham dominating the day. Six of the nine between them. Vane Tempest second. Another very good run here by the mare. She's a snippet son. Takahide Ikenushi, Clint Johnston Porter, and eight All Day Session by Sessions from Simply Irresistible. Sean O'Donnell for trainer Ash Maley. The 10th today, the Raconteur, the feature, comes at 10 after 4 over 1,400. Number 11 is out, Amjad, as we head down to the yard. And Team Williams didn't hesitate coming back 7 days on to pick up a win with Rockanuri today. Britt?
Great training effort this. Grant Williams joins me now. And Grant, I saw you walking out of the races after last week, after this horse's defeat, and you're a bit exasperated by him. How satisfying to come back 7 days later and see him get the job done?
Yeah, it's just, we've had a few like this. They've got ability, but, you know, you've got to teach them how to race. And obviously, I was a bit pissed with myself because of the races. We haven't got that many racing at the moment. We probably just went a week too early. We should have waited for that 1,000. But anyway, now he's got the win for the prep. Hopefully he can go on from this. I still didn't think he hit the line that good, but we'll probably keep him short and maybe put some headgear on down the track.
In terms of how he settled today, how much of it do you look at the tempo of the race, and how much of it is it the fact that he was off 7 days and you gave him a bit of work on Thursday?
Yeah, well, now we have to probably look at 2 or 3 weeks and then go in the same sort of race. And if he does the same thing, we'd take that as a bonus. But if he doesn't, we'll go back to the drawing board.
The headgear that you mentioned, what do you have in mind?
Yeah, I think the Awesome Rocks love the blinkers, and I think down the track we're going to have to put him on. But we're going to have to teach him how to, you know, to race or put him in the right races before we do that. But he looks like he's screaming out for it.
With that in mind, do you just look to keep him at 1,200 at the moment?
Yeah, yeah, we won't go anything past that at the moment, no.
Well, he clearly has ability. Well done on trying to get to the bottom of him.
Thanks, Britt.
There is Grant Williams, Rockonori. He's been so insightful, Grant, all throughout his preparation about what they're doing with this horse. It's nice to see him win. Here's William Pike.
Certainly is. Willie, last week in that 1,400-metre race, just a complete forgive for probably half that field.
Yeah, I suppose there's excuses there, but I suppose back in distance on the back up, sort of knocked some beans out of him, probably done him good.
Is it fair to say coming into this he needed to stand up and sort of be counted?
Yes, absolutely. Always shown good ability, but you like to see him do it again each time they go for a spell. You want to see him raise the bar. So he went a long way to convincing us there.
It sounded like Grant was satisfied with his win, but thought maybe he could have put them away a bit better.
Yeah, that would be my thoughts as well. We had the race won a long way from home, and Vane Tempest was still able to take a bit of ground off us late. But if you look at him in the straight, he's sort of running sideways. He's only playing around. But the problem with him, if you try and go for more, he probably over races. So we're playing the game with him. He's got ability there. How we tap into it, we'll see how it plays out.
Congratulations, well done.
Thank you.
Great insight from both Grant Williams and William Pike on Rockonori, who is still a bit of a work in progress, despite showing plenty of ability. Win number 5 today. Up next from Belmont is our feature of the day. It is the listed Raconteur Stakes. Blame on me. Don't put your blame on me. Oh.